This is episode 72 of the Reading Cove Book Club's podcast. We're always looking for great new members, so if you're a book lover who may be interested in joining an online book club, please visit our website at thereadingcove.com to learn more about the group. For November 2016, we're discussing The Little French Guesthouse by Helen Pollard. So hi, I'm Millenia in Florida.
And I'm Roberta in Georgia.
And Roberta and I are two members of the Reading Cove Book Club here to chat about our 192nd Cove pick, The Little French Guesthouse by Helen Pollard. So how did we like The Little French Guesthouse? And this was chosen by Mary in Scotland, by the way.
Yes. And she, I think she likes like sweeter, cozier stories. And it was. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't say it was, you know, one of my more recent favorite Cove picks, but it was okay. It was okay. You know, it wasn't great literature, but it was okay. Though, and the main thing, I guess, that I didn't give a higher rating was I just felt like it sort of dragged in spots. There was, like, extraneous detail that I didn't feel like was needed. I mean, you want to have a certain amount of story. You don't want just the bare bones about thing, and you want to know a little bit of background. But I just felt like too many things were explored too much in depth, than it would have been just as good, if not better, if the author had gone on and edited it down a little bit more.
So it starts off with a bang, literally.
Yes.
Right? With Emmy catching her boyfriend, Nathan, having sex with the woman who's bed and breakfast they're staying in, or who's what was it, a bed and breakfast, or
it was a guest house? Yes, I said it's a French guest house because I was trying to envision it that not only did you have the main house, but they had, I guess they call them geats or whatever.
Geats, right.
They had separate little small, it's like they were like, sound like they were little small cabins, French style
houses for rent, little houses, right. For rent. They go there for a vacation, and she's trying to shoot some spice back into their relationships, shoot some life back into it, because it's kind of waning after 5 years. She goes up there on the, like, they have a rooftop terrace, and she goes up there and catches them having sex. So you're like, oh my God, okay. Shit's about to hit the fan now, right? So it starts off very engaging, I thought.
Right.
And
right.
You want to know, okay, what's she going to do? What's going to happen? And then it fizzled, for me anyway, because Emmy was so ridiculous in the way she reacted to that. Okay, so he doesn't even ask, Nathan, he doesn't even ask for forgiveness. He is in no way apologetic. They were not apologetic at all, okay? In fact, they were like, so what? Okay, you caught us, get over it.
Yeah.
He did not apologize. He didn't act like he cared that she saw this and that it hurt her. And I thought to myself, well, you should know right then and there, this is not somebody you want to be with. This is not somebody you need to spend another moment giving the luxury of hearing your voice, because he does not have any respect for you whatsoever. And that is what struck me right there at the beginning. So even if this was a comedy, I wasn't laughing, because it's like, where is the respect? He has no respect for you. And she is then proceeding to think that they're going to continue their relationship.
That they can patch it up.
They're going to patch it up. She's willing to forgive him even though he didn't ask to be forgiven. I thought that was the most ridiculous thing on the planet. So I'm just like, now at this point, this girl is too dumb for words. And now I'm just bored. I didn't care what happened with her because he had to dump her. After she catches him having sex with this woman he just met under her nose, he has to dump her. Are you kidding me?
I guess I had to take that she was, you know, I wanted to think the best. I wanted to think, well, she's just in denial and
she's an idiot.
Okay, I wouldn't have been that nice, like, oh, let's talk about it.
I know. Don't you think we should talk about this? Just the whole way that it unfolded from there was just like, okay, Rupert gets carried off, right? Because he was having his episode. And then Nathan is just acting like, oh, nothing happened. And she has to kind of like, oh, what do you have to say for yourself? She's like having to force him to even address it.
Well, I mean, I couldn't blame her totally because they had for wanting to go off on this holiday, you know.
No, that's different. That was before.
Before, but, you know, after that, I would just said, you know, I think I would have dumped his butt, you know, taking the stuff and just say, well, you can find your way back to England. Of course, then there wouldn't have been a book, But you know, if that had happened, then I would have.
That's what I would say. There shouldn't have been a book
Yeah.
because you just cannot justify that level of idiocy. I mean, he did not ask. He wasn't like apologizing. I could see if he was begging forgiveness,
Yes.
then the
Oh, so
story would
sorry.
have some
I'm
legs
just annoyed.
to go on.
Yeah, you know, you could see like, well, he'd care gotten carried away by this, you know, flirtatious, sexy older woman because their relationship had kind of, you know, gotten old and not so spicy anymore that he'd done that. But he said, oh, I'm so sorry. You know, I've gotten carried away. Please forgive me. Yeah, then you could see maybe a different reaction on her part or his part.
Yeah, you could see that this is someone that she's been involved with, living with. She's living with him, and they've
Right.
been together for 5 years, and she's in a bit of shock after what she's seen because she didn't
Yeah.
know he was cheating on her. Because this would lead me to believe that this wasn't the first time he cheated on her. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I have a feeling that he may have lost interest, but it wasn't just because, you know, he was a dull accountant and she was, you know, a businesswoman, and they were both exhausted from their jobs. I think he'd probably been, you know,
Bored.
bored, and he there might have been times when he had found ways to, you know, go off and have a little fling on the side too. So,
The way that he responded to her catching him
yeah.
suggested to me that this wasn't the first time he cheated on her. And the fact that she was such a limp noodle character just leads me to believe, why wouldn't he cheat on her? You know what I mean? She doesn't command any more respect than that, especially in the way that she reacted to him treating her that way. It was like outrageous. It was like outrageously low self-esteem, and you need to go find some self-worth. Because if you want him to respect you need to respect yourself. You need
Yeah.
to demand better respect than that. He didn't even apologize. I just couldn't relate to her. Maybe let me just say that. I'm not gonna say there aren't women like her out there who would react just like that, but I cannot relate to that, because to me that is just like, a step above an IQ of -5. I mean, that's just ridiculous. He does not have any respect for you whatsoever. And you're continuing to think that, okay, let's talk about this. Maybe I can forgive you. He didn't ask you to forgive him. And that conversation just got under my nerves, because it was like, she's sitting here going, okay, well, let's try to work this out. And he's like, I couldn't care less.
You know, he didn't want you could tell from the get-go he didn't want to work
He didn't
there.
care. It was just like, well, you're mad, whatever. Whatever.
Maybe I think maybe because he really hadn't wanted to go on the vacation, and you know, anyway.
It kind of made me wonder, had he just suddenly done a 180 on her? Or had
Yeah.
he been this type of person all along? Because he didn't even seem like a nice guy. The way he spoke about Rupert, he was really insensitive about everything, and he just seemed like a really, unsavory person.
And I don't think he was all that exciting because, you know, that part of his thing that as it went along, it was probably more sort of like a almost a business arrangement with her because here was someone to pay half the expenses, half the mortgage. And it just behooved him to stay with her just to, you know, not have to worry about, you know, having to do all this on his own. But, and who knows, maybe even before they went on the holiday, he thought, okay, well, I'll go on the holiday, but this will be a good time to, while we're away from all these people that know too much about us, it's be a good time to break it off. So I don't know that he was planning to have this wild fling with Gloria, but at the same time, maybe, you know, subconsciously he did this because he did want to break things off because he didn't waste any time packing up and say toodaloo.
No. And then, of course, Gloria was just, equally as horrible.
I'm surprised Rupert married her in the first place,
Yeah.
but I think he was just flattered because she was young and pretty and sexy, and he'd been alone for a long time and probably never had that kind of attention before, but I think with her, it was pretty much an act. She just used her wiles or whatever you want to call it to, you know, try to find a sugar daddy.
Yeah, and just what struck me was their attitudes. I mean, you don't want anything to do with people who treat you like that. I mean, she was very nasty to Rupert. I mean, unless there was some other dynamic where she was getting revenge on him for treating her badly or something, but he didn't seem like that kind of guy. And so she was so disgusting. And then so was Nathan. It was like no sensitivity for her feelings.
Right.
at all. She should not have waited for him to say he's leaving. I'm sorry. And she even thought when he said it that he was referring to them leaving. When he goes, "I'm leaving," she thinks, "Oh, okay, great. Finally, he thinks we need to leave this place where he just slept with the hostess."
And then all said, "Donzer, no, he's going by
himself.
himself."
He says, "No, I mean just me." She's
So why
such
would
an
he leave?
idiot.
I think I would have thrown his suitcases out in the yard.
I would not have slept one more night under that roof, first of
No.
all. I would have been gone.
Yeah, so I would, as I said before, I would have left him there,
Exactly. There's
in the
just no
dust.
way. Where is your self-respect? Where is your sense of worth? She
Yeah, well,
clearly had none.
maybe just part of her own personality, but then also, with living somebody like that, she'd kind of become a doormat. It just had been easier for her to be a doormat and just keep up the status quo, even though it wasn't a really happy one. Just to have to keep from having to make decisions and move on and make other arrangements, because it was going to be re really tough for her to move forward and have to do all the stuff on her own instead of having somebody else. But
Look.
I'd rather do that than have somebody that was bo basically boring and had kind of turned her into a doormat. That would be a lot better outcome. I'd figure you could do somehow, you could get away and get out off on your own.
Yes. And it would have been questionable whether he would have deserved to be forgiven, even if he had asked
Right.
under those circumstances. I mean, they were there on holiday, and there he is up, just, two stones away from her,
Right.
sleeping with this woman. And I mean, even if he had, begged forgiveness and, been remorseful, that would have been questionable whether you should have forgiven him, because that was very outrageous that he would do something like that. Very disrespectful. So the fact that he wasn't even remorseful was, to me, the reason why I lost all interest in Emmy, because it's like, who is she? She's an empty shell. She needed Nathan to be worth something. And then when he leaves, she now is, salivating all over the young gardener.
Well, that was kind of a rebound thing, so it sounds.
Rebound and, whatever. And it just seemed kind of fantasy-like to me, like, oh, it just felt like a fantasy,
But yeah, you could see that he sounded pretty hot, so.
Right. And then, she starts sleeping with him, and then she meets Alan.
Forced into Alan by Rupert,
Right. And then something starts sparking between she and Alan. And then, of course, the very predictable Nathan comes back trying to, patch things up. Okay, we can carry on. And he wasn't even that interested. It was just like, okay, I'm doing it because the script says I should. And then, she's like, got enough sense to say no.
Yeah, she finally gets a spine.
Hopefully, thank God. And then she goes back to France. So I don't know. I did a lot of skimming because I just was not interested in her at all.
You still could have had a similar story, but it could have been done differently with her being a little bit more, less spineless, I should say, not a little bit more
Yeah, I mean, that was ridiculous. Are you
respected.
that blind you can't see when someone is completely disrespecting you?
Yeah.
It was just, yeah, it was a little bit ridiculous. I'm sure there are people like that out there, but God
Oh
bless them.
yeah, you run into people. Unfortunately, I've seen people have, turned into doormats, and it's kind of sad.
At that level, though, at that level where your husband is sleeping with the
No,
the hostess of the place you just met, and you
no,
catch
no,
them and
no,
he doesn't even say sorry,
no, no,
or your boyfriend.
not that bad, not that bad,
That's
bad.
what I mean.
But I'm saying, but there's some people you can meet in real life that are, they've kind of lost part of their
Well, I
self-esteem
know that, but this was just like.
over guys and become doormats. But not, I've never met anybody that bad. No,
Yeah,
please.
that was bad. It
Yeah,
was
yeah.
really bad. And it was just like, oh Lord, what is there to be interested in with this woman? And she wasn't even that young. She's in her 30s. It's
Right.
not like she was 19.
Yeah, if she'd been younger, it would have made more sense. With her being in her 30s, you think by that time at least you should have a little bit more common sense, a little bit
Yes.
more, self-awareness by
Ex
that age.
exactly. And I would have liked this much more. Overall, I will say that I liked the French setting. That made me give it a C rather than a lower grade, because I do love books set in France and stuff. So I liked that aspect of it,
Yeah,
but I just didn't like what was going on in the foreground. I love the background, not the foreground.
Yeah, I agree with you on that part because yeah, I could just kind of see it the way the author described it, and it just looked really pretty to me. And I thought, oh, that would be a, you know, I always wanted to go to Paris, you know, and see all the touristy things. But I thought, but you know, it'd be nice to go to a nice quiet
The
place like
countryside,
that
yeah.
where it's pretty and quiet, and you know, you could just kind of relax and enjoy yourself. So she did make that seem really engaging and pretty. It wasn't the best pick, but it wasn't the worst thing that I've
Right.
ever read either. It was just okay. It could have been a lot better on a lot of levels, but you know, for those who are listening, as we always say, that maybe you have a different opinion. So,
Yeah, maybe you had a different experience reading it.
right.
'Cause I think that's what it's about with books. You know, we all read and have a different experience with the story. So if you guys loved it, please let us know. A lot of people did enjoy this. So I'd love to hear from people what they loved about it and
Right.
what they thought about Emmy's reaction to catching Nathan with Gloria like that. Nathan's being so unapologetic, and even when she's confronted Gloria about it, Gloria was very unapologetic.
Well, it doesn't seem like anybody, like, you know, there in that little area, it didn't seem like Gloria really had any friends.
Friends, yeah.
She had a bad reputation for both those who knew her well and even those who just, you know, knew her by association. So, you know, she was lucky that she had pulled one over on Rupert. Otherwise, she'd probably still be a manager at the whatever place he met her at.
And then Nathan, it seems he went cold on her too, 'cause that's why he wanted to come back to Emmy.
Well, you know, I think he probably realized that, yeah, she was all flirty and you know, hot-blooded and everything, but that she really didn't have any good qualities underneath that. It was just all about what she wanted and what she wanted to have. Because even when Rupert was trying to persuade Emmy to stay on there and you know, help him and not go back home, she said, well, I don't know how you could afford to, you know, pay me. And he's saying, well, think about all the money I've been spending on Gloria for this, that, and the other. All
Exactly.
these luxuries, you think, well, yeah, you know, so.
Yeah, because he was doing all the cleaning and everything. She wasn't lifting a finger.
Yeah, well, yeah, I mean, she was just there for the looks, you know, to look good on the website, look good when the guests came, especially those snobby people, the
The
Hendersons.
Hendersons, yeah.
I don't think they cared who did it. They just, you know, wanted everything very posh for their stay,
Yeah,
so.
and I really didn't like Gloria when she told Rupert, oh, she would be there to help Madam whatever, and oh, everything will be fine. I'll be there to help her. And she knew she was running off with Nathan, that she wasn't going to be there at
I mean, that was just really mean because
Mean.
she knew how bad it, you know, it wasn't like the like Elaine or Alan, what do you call it? He didn't know how bad a shape Rupert had actually been in because, you know, all he knew was about his
His
leg.
leg.
Yeah, he didn't know about, you know, him having this other heart issue. So,
Right.
but she knew everything that was going on, and just to leave him high and dry like that, you know, with only this older lady to, you know, help him out, that was just really low.
Yeah, it was. It was real. And yeah, they're really. I guess that's it. I mean, Rupert was a nice character,
Right.
but they're really. The Emmy, Nathan, and Gloria? No. It was just no, and Emmy was the focal character. She was just yeah. And then the day to day with her there helping Rupert and Mrs. and Madame DuPont, I think her name was. Yeah, it just was boring. I was so bored, and I was just over her. That was me. So I gave it a C because it's a nice French setting.
I said, well, yeah, because I mean, that was me too. As I said, there's just too many minor details that really weren't necessary to get the whole flavor of the book.
Yeah. All right. So that's our discussion of The Little French Guest House by Helen Pollard. Thanks for listening and tuning in. And as always, leave us your comments. Let us know what you thought if you read this book. And if you're going to read the sequel, are you going to read the sequel, Roberta? Return to the.
Very doubtful.
No? Yeah. I would not read it either, unfortunately. Sorry. But if you have read it, comment below and let us know what happens with Emmy in the sequel. And stay tuned for our next episode where we'll be discussing Roberta's pick, The Sound of Glass by Karen White.
Yes.
See you next time. Bye.
Bye.